was a nightmare. You deserve it. Well, you were supposed to protect my great-grandson. And yet that child was stolen right from under your nose because of your foolish choices.
Get out.
Now, if you had only let Nicholas take care of you as he wanted to instead of insisting on working full-time here, you would have carried your baby to term. Your child would have been safely inside.
What the hell are you doing here?
Well, believe me, I'd rather not be. Do you realize that I spent most of that pointless lockdown in the hospital cafeteria? Nicholas, someone has to reprimand this little harlot for having your child in a dangerous environment.
Get out. I'm not going to tell you again. Get out before I throw you out.
My darling, your loyalties are misguided. But suit yourself.
Sorry, I didn't know she was still in the
hospital. Is
she
right?
What?
Is this all my fault?
Epiphany said you wanted to see me.
I want to check myself out of this hospital. If Aiden was with me, I'd already be home. I miss Cameron and Jake, and they need me to help them understand what has happened to their baby brother.
I'm still concerned about you. I know you don't want to hear it.
And I really want to apologize.
Lizzie, you had every reason to be upset about hospital security. You have no idea how terrible I feel. My own nephew stolen right out from under us.
I know. And I'm sorry I lashed out at you when I know you're just as upset as any of us. But the truth is, I'm not exactly blameless here. Franco wouldn't have been able to take Aiden if I had carried him to term, which probably would have happened if I'd listened to Nicholas and just taken it easy.
I don't know what idiot told you that, but it's absurd. You are not to blame for any of this.
Well, that's that. I can officially go home.
Here, I got this.
Thanks. Mm-hmm. And thank you for not fighting me on this.
I know why you want to leave the hospital. I feel the same way.
It's crazy that we came here so excited and full of anticipation. It's amazing how life can just change on a dime.
We'll find Aiden.
I really want to believe that, but we don't know anything, so I don't...
I know. But whatever's happening to Aiden right now, it's out of our control. We have to have faith. This will be with us soon. Hope is all we have right now. We have to hold on to it, all right?
Okay. I'm really glad you're with me.
We'll get through this. So, Willie, let's go. I think you're right to ask Audrey to wait to bring him by. You need to get settled in first, okay?
The house is going to be so empty.